Heather Osmond from the Music and Gospel Arts Department here in the Canada and Bermuda Territory. And this is the first video in a five-part video series called Building Church from Home. And we hope as you watch through this series that we can provide you with some ideas and practical tips to help you as you plan and produce your online worship services. First, as servant leaders, we still need to be asking ourselves, what does our congregation need? And of course, the only way to know that is to stay connected with our congregation. We're not seeing each other on a weekly basis, but phone calls, emails, setting up small group discussions on a conference call, there are still so many ways that we can stay connected. And in that way, we know how our congregation is doing. And as we sit to plan our worship times and pray over our worship times, we should be better able to discern what God is saying to us and to them, what God wants us to hear in scripture, what worship songs may speak to us. And so staying connected with your congregation is very important still. Something else to consider is including others from your congregation. You do not have to do this all on your own. People can help you plan or piece together the final service. Maybe someone can read scripture or provide a musical item. Not only is it a help to you, but remember that all of us are missing our church community. We're not seeing our church family on a weekly basis. So even including others and seeing their face on screen can help your congregation feel connected to each other again. Also remember that short is okay, that the order of service that you would use for your weekly church service in person in your church building will likely look very different than what we're gonna present in an online worship service, and that's okay. Which leads to the next point of trying to engage our listeners early in the service. And there's no cookie cutter answer for this, it depends on your congregation, but what is it that they need to hear the most? And put that at the start of the service. It's likely going to be your message. And putting it first or early in the service is not something that we typically do, but we're delivering it through an entirely different medium. People are sitting at home, watching on their phones or their tablets and the distractions of home around them. So try and engage them with what they need to hear early. We can't worship for the individual, that has to be their own heart, but we still can create the time and the space for them, hopefully, to enter into worship to God with other members of their congregation. We hope that you gain some more ideas and insights as you continue to watch through this series. But as always, if you need any help or have any specific questions, please reach out to the Music and Gospel Arts Department and we'll assist you as best we can. Thank you for watching.